वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर वीके चौहान, होम्योपैथिक फिजिशियन एंड वी आर रिवाइजिंग इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन ब्रीफ इन साइकोलॉजी फॉर फर्स्ट BHMS स्टूडेंट्स। आवर टॉपिक नंबर 31 इज बिहेवियरिस्टिक स्कूल एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस टू होम्योपैथी। सो लेट अस गो अहेड। We'll recall that behaviorism refers to the school of psychology founded by John B. Watson. He is considered to be the father of behavioristic psychology, along with Edward Thorndike, Ivan Pavlov, B.F. Skinner and Albert Bandura. Behaviorism, also known as behavioral psychology, is a theory of learning based upon idea that all behaviors are acquired through conditioning. Conditioning occurs through interaction with the environment. Behaviorists believe that our responses to environmental stimuli shape our actions. Watson's work included the famous Little Albert experiment, in which he conditioned a small child to fear a white rat. John B. Watson, who suggested that all behaviors are a result of learning process, therefore behavior can be measured, trained, and can be changed. Homeopaths are concerned with the personality, how we behave from the point of view of individualization. If a person has maladaptive behavior patterns, then if we can identify and help changing his high-risk behavior, which predisposes him to a number of diseases. Here, homeopaths believe that if they can give a constitutional medicine, they can change the behavior. But from the concept of psychology, it is not possible, because whatever we are doing in terms of our behavior, we have learned it and we have to modify it through the techniques of relearning new things. So constitutional medicines are good. They may help you in certain ways, but they will never be able to change your attitude, aptitude, and your behavior pattern. You need to take help of psychology and tools of psychology. And for example, hypertension, coronary artery disease, peptic ulcer, obesity, obsessive compulsive disorder, anorexia nervosa, IBS or irritable bowel syndrome, conversion reaction, which we see in hysteria, most of the hysterical remedies we have, somatoform disorders, addiction to alcohol and smoking. So these are the behaviors which are learned behavior. The maladaptive behavior is also acquired, hence can be modified. It means that all it takes is the right conditioning to change the behavior. Types of behavior conditioning we have. Number one, a classical conditioning, and number two is operant conditioning. The classical conditioning, it is the technique used in behavioral training in which a naturally occurring stimulus is paired with the response. And B is the operant conditioning, sometimes referred as instrumental conditioning. It is the method of learning that occurs through reinforcement and punishment for behavior. When a desirable result follows an action, the behavior becomes more likely to occur again in the future. What is the utility we have? Effective therapeutic techniques such as intensive behavioral intervention, behavioral analysis, token economies, and discrete trial training all are rooted in behaviorism. These approaches are often very useful in changing maladaptive or harmful behavior in both children and adults. Bibliography. We have taken help of all these sites to prepare this particular small talk. Thank you very much for patient listening.